Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review today. I'm here to tell you all about the latest from Catatonia, Siri Burials, out April 24th on Peaceville. The album has 11 tracks, 49 minutes in length, and this is the band's 11th full-length studio album. This is Catatonia, but I feel like it's Catatonia being delivered on a much different package or in a different box. What I mean by that is that all the elements that we've gotten used to from the band as far as their sound, the melancholy of their sound, the atmospheric soundscapes, the great vocals, the emotional lyrics, all of those elements are present in this record. The way they're structured, the way they're delivered, the way they're arranged, that to me is where the differences lie as far as this album is concerned. Starting off with the structure, I felt that this album had a very faint heartbeat style structure. What I mean by that is that it's very linear at times and then it peaks and it comes back again very quickly into this flatline mode, and then it peaks again, coming back again to this flatline mode. So it feels like a faint heartbeat style structure to the album. Having said that, that same structure then migrates from the overall feel of the record into the individual tracks. You get some songs where there's this flatline emotional feeling that goes through 90% of the song, with then a peak happening that just kind of throws you for a loop, that just changes the dynamic of the track, and then returning back to that flat line. So you see that structure that's on the overall record being transferred to the individual tracks for the most part of it. Obviously, there's some tracks that are almost just plain flat line, just really linear, just really melancholic, really somber, really dark all the way through, where there's absolutely no light, no intensity coming through any of the darkness that makes up those songs. But overall, when you look at the overall album, it has this feeling of peaking, coming back down, flatlining, peaking again. So that's why I say this album has a faint heartbeat style structure. Besides the structure, to me there are three elements that really make up the main sound and the overall the main life of the record, and that to me is the keyboards, the guitars, and the vocals. You cannot talk about this album and not mention these three elements, because outside of the structure, outside of the overall structure of the album, these three elements really define what this album is all about. Starting off with the keyboards, because I feel they're one of the most important elements of this album. The keyboard melodies are absolutely incredible. Very atmospheric, not always melodic, but very atmospheric. They really use the keyboard well to create this incredible soundscape that permeates from the first song all the way through. In some tracks, the keyboards migrate from that more atmospheric soundscape to a more melodic approach, really giving a different energy, giving a different balance to the tracks. But overall, the keyboards and the way they sound throughout the record just really have this fog of emptiness to it that just permeates, just goes and absorbs every single track. There's not one song where you don't have it. The question is how much you get it on every single song. To me, one of the main components of the atmosphere of the record, but also one of the main components of the overall great sound that this album has. As far as the guitars are concerned, I felt that at points the guitars lacked a little bit of bite, but what they lacked in bite, they added in melancholic emptiness. I really feel the sound that you get from these guitars, heavy at times, but it's very faint. The same way the structure has these fainted heartbeats to it, the overall sound of the guitars on this album lacks bite, very fainted from that perspective, fainted of almost empty of heaviness, but it does carry this melancholic emptiness to it. So it's another element that adds a lot of atmosphere to the overall sound of the album, not making the album overly aggressive or over intensive. I actually don't feel like this is an aggressive or even slightly intensive album. It's really even and it's really leveled. It's really balanced all the way through, the guitars being another element that's pretty balanced all the way through. There are some songs where you get a little bit more of an edge coming out of the guitars, but it's so sparse. It happens here and there. It's not really continuous. So when you look at the overall picture of the album, you just feel like the guitars kind of came under the radar and not being one of the main driving forces of the album. They're almost there just for atmospheric purposes. They're just there to create a nice nuance, a nice balanced sound throughout the album, but they're definitely not the driving force of this record. To me, the driving force of this record is the last element, and that is the vocals. They are the calling card of this album. They add everything that you need. They're very leveled. Once in a while, they just jump a little bit an intensity. They gain a little bit more of an intensity. They gain a little bit more momentum. They gain more volume. But overall, when you look at the vocals throughout the record, very, very balanced, very linear all the way through. But definitely the driving force of the album, everything rotates around the vocals and around the vocal approach. The vocals are the sun. Everything else are the planets that just circulate around it. That is how this album is put together. That is how this album is designed. I love the vocal approach. It has so much emotion built in into it, really bringing the lyrics to life and really giving life to the songs. I also like some of the layers that they did as far as adding a little bit more texture, adding a little bit more volume, giving a little bit more presence to the way the overall sound of the record, but also giving a little bit more presence to the overall vocals and specific songs really needed, because they were so dulling that you needed something that just changed the intensity without really changing the individual dynamics of the song. So they did that by adding a few vocal layers or by increasing slightly the intensity of the style of the approach of the vocals to just give the songs a little bit of a difference, just to push them a little bit further, to move the needle a little bit more. Overall, this album is Catatonia. Not Catatonia of old, but Catatonia of now. So if you're going into this record expecting old Catatonia, I think you're gonna walk away disappointed, because there are some remnants there, but it's not old Catatonia. It's a new style, it's a new approach. Same old band, but just new delivery. That's what you're gonna get from this album. Still a very good record, a very solid record, a very different record that to me took a few times going through before I could really get used to the sound, get used to the approach, and really enjoy the album. Once I did, then I was fully committed to the record. But this is not an album that at the first time going through you will immediately grasp all the little nuances, all the little ideas, all the little concepts that the band is trying to put forward with this record. Still staying true to the band, but still trying to branch out and take steps further to expand their sound and to expand what they can do musically. That's what this album, in my opinion, really does for them. As far as songs are concerned, I want to start off with Heart Set to Divide. This is the opening track on the album. Really dark, somber riff matching the overall keyboard atmospheric soundscape. The two really come together and you really have this really dynamic, somber track all the way from the beginning to the end. The song has a feeling of building up, and it builds up as far as intensity is concerned, and then it dips again. It really feels like it comes in waves. This is a song that you almost feel the emotional drive of the track is coming and going, almost like the tides of the ocean. The vocals are very leveled all the way through. They added some layers to the vocals, and then, in my opinion, added texture, it added darkness, and it really made the overall sound of the track a lot more dynamic. This is a very dynamic track. There's a lot of different moving pieces, both from a sound and from a vocal perspective. Next, Rain. The vocals in this song move the track. They dictate where the track goes. They are the GPS of the song, really telling exactly where they need to go, where they want to go. They are the driver of this song. The track overall has a very melancholic, dulling sound in the verses, more melodic and dynamic in the chorus. It's really a song that's divided between those two portions of the track. Both vocally and musically, you feel the difference. It's a song that comes in two different parts, right? So you get the more dullness, both vocally and musically in the verses, and then you get this more intense, this more enigmatic approach in the chorus, really creating this yin and yang between those two parts of the song, almost creating a full-on roller coaster ride, because they move very quickly between them. I really like that approach. It really gives the song a very forward motion, even in the parts that are a lot slower. There's a really great melancholic bridge that really extends the track, but it also adds a little bit of pain and suffering to the overall sound that this song has, making the chorus that follows it and that closes the song feel heavier, sound heavier, have a lot more presence, to be a lot more robust. One of the heavier tracks when you look specifically at the choruses and how they're put together. Last, Vanishers. This features Annie Bernhard from a band called Full of Keys. What a great addition. I was blown away. This is my favorite song on the album. One of the most beautiful, dark, and somber tracks that you will hear on this record. Incredible vocal duet that will blow your mind. It is just memorable in all facets of the track. This song is just outside the box. It's just one of those magnificent tracks that will remain magnificent year after year. I mean, it could be 100 years from now, you look back at this song and you're still gonna be blown away by the quality of the track. Incredible vocal duet. The vocals are just out of this world. I cannot emphasize how good the vocals, both vocals, are on this song. The melody of the chorus is just sensational. A song that, in my opinion, has a more stripped down effect in the verses, where the two vocals really command the presence and the attention during that more stripped down melancholic feel. And when it gets to the chorus, it becomes a lot more bombastic. It gains a little bit more momentum, it gains a little bit more intensity, but more importantly, it gains a lot more melody. And even the vocals change ever so slightly to add a lot more melody to the overall sound. Magnificent song, my favorite song on the record. All right, guys, this is it. This is Catatonia with City Burials. Once again, out April 24th on Peaceville. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those, getting back to you. Take care, guys.